guys, what's up? It's currently 10 a.m. A good day, but I am starting my next vlog, and I shall see you in the morning, bitches. Hey guys, what's up? I got home a little while ago. I'm so tired. I can't even function. This is a problem. Just chomping on some grapes. I don't have enough footage, so. Good morning, bitches. This weirdo. Wait, flipped you over. I think. Good morning, all. Footage, so I'm gonna try and vlog today as much as I can. So yeah, he loves me, I swear. Say hi. Hi, buddy. It's the best I've ever looked.
Hi, buddy. Good morning, little fool. Hey, you, Grumpo. Grumpo, hi. Good morning, puss. So grumpy, but so cute. Hey. Oh, I suck. Hi. Red. Jerk. Anyway, I'm just waiting for my mom. Got my boots on. I'll show you. Boom. My white girl socks. And this jerk won't even say goodbye to me. Yeah. That one over there, the face, the cute little face and the food all over the floor. Ah, anyway, I think I'm heading out soon, so yeah, bye.
Records.kungfustore.com, RAMSEUR, RAMSEUR.kungfustore.com. I want to make a mention of something really cool that I just found out. They have just signed the Brooklyn-based rock and roll band, the National Reserve, a really, really good band. And in fact, while I tell everyone about this real quick, Jen, let me play a little bit of music behind me so you can hear a little bit of the National Reserve.
I swear to God, it happens several times a year where there's like a burst of tweets. And I know you experience this too, where all of a sudden there's some video or some clip or some meme that becomes so big that all of a sudden everyone starts tweeting you. And usually it's like once a quarter, once every season. There's a new batch of people that discovered Tommy Young putting Nikita's penis back in time at Starrcade 86, and they sent it to me.
But, you know, but actually I've seen some other ones with Tommy, like Tommy Young's reaction, the perfect reaction. I used to actually show the tape in wrestling school in OVW to train the referees on how to do this. It was so perfect. Where he catches, he's counted three for Wyndham to pin Flair and win the title, but then he just, as soon as he goes down for the three, he sees the leg on the ropes, and oh my God, the way he puts it over. Just his verbal, when Arn Anderson gave the guy the gourd buster, the look he would have, he's a meme factory as Tommy Young. He was in a class by himself.
I think one of the coolest things,
he had his fist on his forehead and this downtrodden look on his face, like, oh my God, I have erred in this. He was Shakespeare as a fucking referee, I'm telling you.
I know you said you brought him into Smoky Mountain early on to help train Hildebrand into being a great referee. And Brian Hildebrand was a fantastic referee, maybe the best referee after Tommy Young. In fact, I'll erase the word maybe in my eyes. The best referee after Tommy Young. But how much did he really teach you? How much was actually in Brian? Because he was such a big wrestling fan. He had done managing. He had trained to be a wrestler with Dominic Canucci. How much did he learn from Tommy Young, and how much did he already know?
Oh, well, see, here's the thing. Brian already knew the wrestling business from a lot of different sides, but he hadn't refereed that much. And Tommy was also, he was there to carry the finishes from one locker room to the other and help agent, help with the music. But part of it was to watch and
see when you fuck up something and tell you about it type of coaching. And it worked. I guess Brian obviously knew that Tommy was the best. He wasn't going to act like Tommy Young, because part of the reason why Tommy Young was Tommy Young is because it was unique. Anybody else acted that way, it wouldn't have worked. But he, you know, from a timing thing of being experienced.
Tommy Young, who end up, when they're running in the Carolinas against Mid-Atlantic, staying with Mid-Atlantic after the promotion folds.
Well, yeah, as a matter of fact, I just did a Back to the Territories with Bill Eadie on Georgia. But he, you know, he mentioned his run in the Carolinas. And in fact, he was on the Mongol side, part of the Mongols when they were on the All-South side in the Georgia War. I guess so.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
So he had worked, but George Scott liked his work in the Carolinas and wanted to replace, I think, the spoiler, Jardine, when he was leaving with another top mask guy. And they just picked Bill and he had, you know, he had never appeared as that person before for an outlaw promotion, and they had respect for him, you know, for just, at that time, basically, he was not one of the movers and shakers of the thing. He was just a guy that had a job. So they redeemed him out of outlaw hell.
Is it weird for you when you sit down and talk with someone who is a year maybe?
Several rolled over by accident. Sheik is the most notable one. But the deal was, it was because if they were so rotten and couldn't perform at a decent enough level that you just sent them home, you had to pay them because you'd sign them a contract, and it's not their fault. There's no clause in the contract says this guy sucks so bad I can just tell him to leave. So they would get paid, but they'd be sitting home and nobody'd be thinking about them. And nobody would remember that they were around. Herd was such a fucking idiot, he couldn't even have a goddamn list that he could look at. And so the time to give the notice would come by without them getting a notice, and the contract would roll over. They'd have to pay him for another year. But if you guys like me and Bobby Eaton and Dennis Condrey, every single year in the spring when our contracts were up that Jim Herd was around, we got the termination letter FedEx to our house a couple days before the fucking deadline. That, not that we were fired, but that we had to start all over again negotiating the contract. Because he was always giving him his notice.
I bet you the Sheik forgot, too, that he had the contract after.
No, I bet you the Sheik didn't forget when he had that fucking envelope in the mailbox every fucking week.
Well, one more question. George Scott made me think of this. Did you ever actually meet at any time John Ringley?
No, he was gone by the time that I ever even got really into business as a photographer.
No, I knew that, but I knew he was, you know, I mean, he was partners with George Scott when they started up, what, South Atlantic Pro Wrestling?
And by that time, when they started, I was already WCW and then heading toward Smoky Mountain, and I never really worked for those guys I watched the show on TV because I was in Charlotte.
I just didn't know if he would ever been around in any way that you would have run into him or met him.
No, I never met him, but I'd like to congratulate him for having the balls to fuck around on Francis.
Well, with that, like we said, the top 10 brought to you by Ramsar Records, who we plugged about an hour ago. Let's get going.
To him and whisper tender words so soft and sweet. Hold him close to feel his heartbeat. Offer me the gift you give yourself. Love is like that surely glow in the hearts of those who know. It's a steady flame that grows. Fever fire with all the passion you can show. Tell him that the sun and moon.
Bye.